This is Designing Spaces Think Green, the show that's all about you, your living space, and living a more eco-friendly lifestyle. Today, we look at how homes are being transformed into more efficient and sustainable living spaces that benefit the occupants and the community around them. A healthier environment means healthier lives for all of us. So let's get started and think green. Greener homes are more efficient with airtight seals. But what about stale air? Closed-in air can become a potential health hazard. Think Green goes to Atlanta, Georgia to see firsthand how the right kind of ventilation is improving indoor air. Today's homes are designed and built to improve energy efficiency. These airtight designs are constructed using house wraps, newly designed windows and doors, ceiling caulks, and other insulating materials. The resulting benefit is fewer drafts, which lowers the cost to heat and air condition a home. However, these airtight homes may actually cause health problems and jeopardize structural integrity due to the buildup of pollutants, moisture, and uncirculated stale air. Poor indoor air quality can contribute to asthma, headaches, dry eyes, nasal congestion, nausea, and fatigue. The solution? Proper ventilation.
So if you talk about pollutants, such as mold and mildew, can get locked in that home because the home cannot breathe as much.
Angy Steiner is the National Accounts Manager for Panasonic Ventilation Group and specializes in indoor air quality.
So when air moves through a house, the concept would be with whole house ventilation. Your installed fan would be running, and as it's ventilating out all that bad air, you're getting an air exchange within your home, which is circulating and moving that air throughout your whole house.
A fan that can be used to comply with industry building codes to be able to help with both intermittent and continuous ventilation.
Intermittent, or another word is spot ventilation, and that's to get the bad air out of the actual bathroom, let's just say. And another way is continuous ventilation, and that's for the health or indoor air quality of the entire home.
The fan is uniquely quiet when running, using reduced energy, a significant help to lowering the electric bill.
Our fans are all certified by the EPA, the Energy Protection Agency, and they're all certified Energy Star fans and fan lights.
This is Patricia Monks. She has a ventilation system in her bathroom, but it has been unplugged almost immediately after moving in. Indoor air quality is one of the Environmental Protection Agency's top five environmental risks to public health. Think Green visited South Face in Atlanta, Georgia, a nonprofit organization that for more than 30 years has promoted energy, water, and resource-efficient workplaces, homes, and communities. Here, Angy met with Patricia to show her what home ventilation can do to contribute to a healthier interior environment.
Yeah, Angy, I've spent a lot of money updating my bathroom with new fixtures and, you know, other, you know, the tile work. And one thing that's really bothering me is the vent fan. I didn't even think to change it out, but quite honestly, it just sits there. We haven't used it in years.
While doing her research, she learns more about the importance of constant air movement taking place in the home.
I'm finding that it's important that there's constant air movement in the house. And I'm just concerned that I'm not really getting that right now. My husband has allergies. I'm concerned about my son maybe getting allergies.
Things like mold and mildew and pollutants, when you talk about asthma and allergies, those things can really affect that. And then also things like volatile organic compounds, we call them VOCs, things from off-gassing from your new construction things that you do in that bathroom. What we're looking to do today with Patricia is actually meet Brad from South Face. And we're going to go look at our installed fan and see that it's actually working properly and show how we can get bad air and how a fan gets bad air out of the home. Our Whisper Green LED lighted fan is green because of a few things. It's energy efficiency, it's sustainability, it's for indoor air quality, and also lower operating costs. And the LED lighting is only using 12 watts of energy, where an incandescent lamp today runs at 75 watts.
I can barely hear the fan.
Just because the ventilation is not noisy does not mean it's not working efficiently. Quite the contrary.
Yeah, so I've got a smoke stick here, and if you can just imagine that this the smoke that's going to be coming out of here is your bad indoor air, right? It's your steam, it's your VOCs, it's your pollutants, it's the nasty smell from your bacon and burnt fish. And believe it or not, as quiet as it is, it's still exhausting all of this air out of your living space.
This simple tool is used to demonstrate the cubic feet per minute rate, also known as CFM, showing how much air is actually sucked out of the space.
So Brad is using an exhaust fan flow meter to measure the CFM and the flow of the hood to actually see that the fan is running at the rated level that we have it rated for. And it is working very well. It's flowing at a little over 80 CFM, and it's an 80 CFM rated fan.
The contractor that installed this in this space, he did a ventilation calculation to determine exactly how much flow was needed to exhaust the air from the space, and he determined that 80 CFM was the proper amount.
I'm really glad to have a better understanding of just how important the air quality in my home is, and the fact that I can have a fan, a ventilation unit that can help me not only protect my family, but protect my structure and my home.
For more information, visit panasonic.com/ventfans. To see this portion of the show again and see other Think Green episodes, go to designingspaces.tv and click onto the Think Green section. We'd love to hear your comments. Be a friend on Facebook at @dspacesTV. We all want clean water and a healthy ecosystem. And we all want to find ways to lower our cost of living and run more efficient households. The new technologies are here now, improving our lifestyles and the environment. Let's keep moving in the right direction and think green.
You can visit these websites to learn more about the participants on this edition of Designing Spaces.